Melbourne City Council is making a bold promise to clean up all graffiti in just 2 weeks. Heidi Murphy's in Kensington. Heidi, it's a full makeover.
That's right, Pete. That's certainly the plan. Revealed in a letter to ratepayers today, the City Council says it wants to get rid of all visible tagging in the city centre, then move to inner suburbs like this one to do a major clean-up as well. Now, we all love our street art, but it's the ugly tagging you can see behind me that isn't a good look or feel for the city. Now, people I've spoken with today say, look, a blitz is welcome, but it will take more than just one to clean the city up. And business owners, a little tired of hearing promises, very keen to see a proper clean-up delivered.
Fed up with tagging around his Docklands business, Andrew Ward has been taking matters into his own hands for months now.
I went and bought my own paint, my own rollers, and spent my own time rolling and painting all the graffiti.
He'd been writing to the city and getting nowhere.
The graffiti is disgraceful.
Well, till now, there is a new blitz to start on Sunday, and it's an ambitious one. In a letter to property owners, City Council says to make the city as attractive as possible, they'll try to remove all graffiti tagging in sight. There'll be a 2-week blitz in the CBD, then a push into suburban streets and lanes, the council telling residents they can opt out if they like the tags on their properties. The experts say one blitz will not be enough.
What would be good would be to see an ongoing program to ensure that they don't return. It's a matter of just being consistent.
And there are those who don't think it's a problem that needs fixing.
There is a beauty to tagging that can't be denied. I understand why the council wants to remove this sort of stuff, but I feel like, in a way, it's a waste of money.
Business owners, though, will be hoping this blitz works.
It's more important the area is clean, no graffiti, rather than trying to pay people to come with vouchers back to the city.
It's not going to disappear. It's been around for 20, 30 years and it will always be around.
Heidi Murphy, Nine News.